From this evening, I must give the British people a very simple instruction. You must stay at home. Because the critical thing we must do to stop the disease spreading between households.
To help save lives, stay at home. Anyone can spread coronavirus. You should now only go out when absolutely necessary.
To applaud our NHS heroes. The UK and the rest of the world are going through something the like of which has never been seen.
All around the UK, people are being urged to open their windows, go to their front doors and applaud the
yes.
NHS helpline.
Hey. Woo!
Scotland the Brave, along with everybody
who is applauding all of the key workers who are keeping our country should be free. I wish I could be like a bird in the sky. How sweet it would be if I found
not a soul to be seen.
Well, I'd soar to the sun and look down.
Outdoor exercise. If people ignore the lockdown rules on staying at home and social distancing.
The step to ban exercise of all forms outside of your own home, then you've got to follow the rules.
I wish I knew.
I'm not leaving you. I'm going to my grandson's.
So we've got a little bit of social distance gardening going on.
He's bringing a Sunday focus into an everyday focus. He's bringing our gatherings into community.
Part of the team, and it's my joy to share the Word of God with you.
I'm speaking to you at what I know is an increasingly challenging time. A time of disruption in the life of our country. A disruption that has brought grief to some, financial difficulties to many, and enormous changes to the daily lives of us all. I want to thank everyone on the NHS frontline, as well as care workers and those carrying out essential roles who selflessly continue their day-to-day duties outside the home in support of us all. I'm sure the nation will join me in assuring you that what you do is appreciated and every hour of your hard work brings us closer to a return to more normal times. I also want to thank those of you who are staying at home, thereby helping to protect the vulnerable and sparing many families the pain already felt by those who have lost loved ones. Together we are tackling this disease, and I want to reassure you that if we remain united and resolute, then we will overcome.
Yeah, it's been good. Yeah, I'm glad the week is finished now. So yeah, that's really good.
She worked for the NHS as an admin for the health visitors, and I'm really proud of
her. Yeah, well done you. Can you hold it up a bit to your left so you can see it? That's it, brilliant. Look at that. I wish you all health and happiness. Stay home and stay safe. Monitoring during the early phase of his recovery. Of course, the key words in there, recovery and early phase.
Don't forget me. He said, don't forget me on the cross. And I wonder actually, as we choose to lay down certain things, as we choose to voluntarily give up, where other people in the world are crying.
Broken, wafer and crooked, that we receive them.
That the Prime Minister's condition continues to improve.
Baby, can I hold you tonight? Maybe if I told you the right words at the right time, then you'd be mine. Baby, can I hold you? Okay.
Take this time to acknowledge and honor the sacrifices of those who work every day taking care of their communities in this time of need and uncertainty. The heroes who are making our daily lives possible, let's continue to support them and each other. This is Hero.
There's a hero. If you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid.
Hello!
Happy Easter! Happy Easter!
Jesus is alive!
Hallelujah!
Right?
Do
absolutely
you agree?
Absolutely not, yeah. We need to find these things.
Your face.
Picnic hunt with mother. The roles have been reversed.
Welcome to the kitchen of our home on Easter Day, where we will celebrate together the story of God's saving work in the resurrection of His Son, Jesus Christ.
He left hospital after a week in which the NHS has saved my life, no question. It's hard to find words to express when the sun is out and the kids are at home, when the whole natural world seems at its loveliest and the outdoors is so inviting. I can only imagine how tough it has been to follow the rules on social distance.
So we're into week four now of social distancing, isolation, and what we're calling a lockdown. I mean, there's no such thing now as rushing to work at 8 a.m. and queuing in traffic because there just is no traffic on the roads. It's a really weird thing to say that I actually miss rush hour. That's got to be a first, right? An exciting delivery.
Garden furniture's arrived.
Oh, I'm just really pleased with it. It's really nice, look at it.
Hey.
Do you like it, Bonnie?
No, not too sure.
Think about it. This will all be like a bad dream. We'll wake up and read about the days of quarantine. The calendar droppers and the house party rockers. And the TikTokers, channel hoppers, toilet rolls, stockers, and the pajama boppers. The conspiracy blockers, Wi-Fi blockers, fridge suckers, new stoppers. Yeah, it's time to start it at the smart. We need to come together by just keeping apart.
What are you thinking?
I don't like rugs.
Don't like rugs? Well, that's not helpful considering we're here to actually buy a rug. So much in the last episode of season four of Ally McBeal.
This is the episode that launched Josh Groban's career, according to him.
I love that Aussie accent. I wish that I could talk like that all the time.
So I'm on my way at last, off to Hereford. I'm going to meet the family for the first time in
Look at you!
Hello!
Do I know? What? In what?
A car.
You've asked me a very technical question there. I'm not sure what type of engine is in a car. It's really good to see you.
Oh, brilliant.
Just get a look at that beautiful sunset. Look what I bought for you. Bunny! Oh, and she just walks away. So unappreciative.
We just heard about Simon Cowell breaking his back in a bike accident. A bit unlucky the last few years.
I probably wouldn't challenge somebody myself. One of my favourite moments was still the VE Day evening when we all sat on the end of the driveway at night listening to old 40s music. So I'm still watching The Fall. I'm getting to the end now of season three. No spoilers. But it's really bad because I kind of fancy the killer. I'm
tired, Charlie.
There we go, buddy.
shoes might be in order, come.
What have you been doing?
Pulling out the ice creams.
Oh, I expect a lot's gone on a day like this, right?
I put it out and it immediately gets stolen.
Wow.
Immediately.
Wow.
It's not good.
I'm wondering if the storm has put my appliances out. Okay, I'm going to go and try the switches again, the fuse box.
Maybe it just needs to dry out overnight. I can't even unplug it because the plug is right at the back and I can't pull any of it out.
Zoom was really, really good. It's so good just to see everybody's faces. It's weird because this time last year, never even heard of Zoom. Someone put in the chat Matthew 18, where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I also. And there God is also in the chat like that, over the internet, over the Wi-Fi. Such funny times we're living in. Not funny ha-ha either, funny strange. Okay, we're off on our holidays. Just half an hour behind schedule. You ready, boys? Duh. In East Devon coast. Does that mean that dinosaurs once stood here? Do you think?
All right, we're gonna jump in.
Yeah, I don't think
probably
so. Aww. Hello, little buddy. Aww. Aww, he's really sweet. Little face. Aww, he looks like you, Marcus.
What?
Kind of mohawk hairdo.
It's so confusing, it's so many rules to follow. What I'm feeling, cause I just run away in my mind.
The big ball.
Marcus! Hey, hey, we're the monkeys. No monkey around. Aww.
I'll get you out of there, mate.
Aww. Can't really see his face like that.
I want to break him out.
I'm a dweller on the threshold. And I'm waiting at the door.
And I'm I can't decide if that's sweet or creepy. That's what do you think? Great.
As I cross the burning ground, let me go down to the water. Watch the great illusion.
Who is that guy? Is he? Oh, he's from New Kids on the Block. Oh my god. I just cut out of magazines all sorts of random stuff. I mean, we've got Columbo. There's Neighbours again, the Blue Peter team. And then this is the daily diary that I kept. I would write every single day. This is 1991.
gosh, it makes me want to party.
Down in the hollow, playing a new game, laughing and a running, hey, hey, skipping and a jumping. In the misty morning fog with all our hearts a thumping, and you, my brown eyed girl.
Would think you were training for a marathon.
Yeah, I wish I was.
Two marathons have been cancelled now, haven't they, Con? Two marathons. This is such a surreal Britain's Got Talent year. Oh my gosh, look at that virtual audience. Is this your favourite one?
So far, yeah.
I think I look good under these lights. Boris Johnson was in Solihull the other day visiting the HS2 project. I just think that train is a massive waste of money.
I mean, Mark, do you think it's really important to get to London 20 minutes quicker at the cost of 200 million, or is it billion?
No, I think all the dead animals.
Dead animals?
Are less likely to die from this disease, be in no doubt that they are still at risk. The long-term effects can be terrible, and of course, they can infect others.
With 63,
okay, so Bolton currently has the highest number of coronavirus cases. Oh God, I've just caught a spider using the spider catcher. Let's get him as far away from here as possible. Ew. It's some socially distanced Coronation Street.
Sure.
Oh man, I'm so fed up of social distancing. Must be a nightmare for these productions.
Oh, do you need more? Is there something else you're searching for? I'll fall in all the good times.
Ah, McFly singing tributes with the NHS. Ah, nice upbeat song as well for these COVID times.
Hence the noise over the fence.
So yeah.
Swap houses.
Yeah, because from tomorrow we can't mix houses.
You can't mix them.
No.
I'm still doing my garden though, but I'll be coming through the back way.
Yeah. Yeah. That will still be allowed.
It's a bonfire in the middle of September. Oh, it's a bit nippy now, isn't it? Ooh.
Okay.
Faces down, our hands are raised. You called us out. We turned away. We've turned away. With shipwrecked faith, the idols rise. We do what is right.
You get to see the group again.
Our children now will pay. Shine your light. If we've ever needed you, Lord, it's now. Lord, it's now. We are desperate for your hand. We're reaching out. We're reaching out. In our hearts and lives, let your church arise, let your church arise. If we've ever needed you, Lord, it's now. Lord, it's now.
Hey boys, it's Saturday night.
Saturday night.
Woo!
Are you excited about Strictly Come Dancing?
I'm not watching that.
It's dancing, what's not to like?
Boring!
What seriously made me laugh was Manchester. A restaurant up there called The Spin has come up with this burger called the three-tier Boris Burger. It's my lockdown project, building the friend set. I think I did it back in about May. Yeah, it basically took me about 5 days, I think it was. So yeah, it was really intricate with all of the pieces. There was one little fiddly bit that I couldn't quite do, so I left it. You wouldn't really notice it. But I'm just really, really proud of it. I did think about just dismantling it and flogging it on eBay. But then I thought, well, you know what? This reminds me of my lockdown experience in a way. And I'm just really proud of it, so I'm going to keep it.
Fabulous, thank you very much.
We love you, Nana. We've got you a present.
Da 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 da. Social distance thumbprinting on the new iPad.
Social distancing scenes in EastEnders. This must be a real nightmare for Phil Mitchell because he can't do any fight scenes.
As the economy reopens, it is fundamentally wrong to hold people in jobs that only exist inside.
I'm on this platform scene. I'm in the top left corner. Millie shot this scene about 30 times, speaking to the camera. I had a lot of fun with all of these guys.
So I'm currently waiting for Green Flag to come and get me. You know, you know. Max Irons, well, we do have money on him to be the next Bond.
I'll have a martini on the rocks, shaken, not stirred.
James Bond. James Bond.
Keeping the British end up, sir.
Do you mind if my friend sits this one out? She's just dead.
He always did have an inflated opinion of himself.
Now there's a name to die for. Ain't it stars tonight? So watch me bring the fire, set the night light. Shoes on, get up in the morning, cup of milk, let's rock and roll. Kink out, kick the drum, rolling on like a rolling stone. Sing song when I'm walking home, jump up to the top of LeBron. Ding dong, call me on my phone, nice tea and I'll get my ping pong. This is dead heavy.
He projects that he's crossed the threshold of 270 electoral college votes needed with a win in the state of Pennsylvania.
If you count the legal votes, I easily win. If you count the illegal votes, they can try to steal the election from us.
Let's
let's run through the details.
Okay, here we have it.
Between December the 23rd and December the 27th, a maximum of 3 households from anywhere in the UK will be able right. to meet up and form a Christmas bubble. You can only meet up inside each other's homes, outdoors, or places in the
world. White Christmas with every Christmas card I write. The pub over there, the Alton Tab, one of our locals. They're not even allowed to open today because we're in tier 3.
Vaccine
approved, yes. Oh, they're rolling out the vaccine.
Do you think you'll be able to only eat one a day of those, Mum?
Hi Yana, it is Ben Hall here, aka Ned Willis from Neighbours. Happy birthday, I hope you're having a wonderful day.
Very good day, Matt Hancock, and you have every reason to smile.
So, look, such a small thing, just having that jab in the arm, but it means so much because this is the route out of this pandemic, and by God, we need one.
It is with a very heavy heart, I must tell you, we cannot continue with Christmas as planned.
Well, folks, we're coming to the end of 2020, a year in which the government was forced to tell people how to live their lives, how long to wash their hands, how many households could meet together, and a year in which we lost too many loved ones before their time. And so I can imagine that there will be plenty of people who will be only too happy to say goodbye to the grimness of 2020. But just before we do, I want to remind you that this was also the year when we rediscovered a spirit of togetherness, of community. It was a year in which we banged saucepans to celebrate the courage and self-sacrifice of our NHS staff and care home workers. A year in which working people pulled the stops out to keep the country moving in the biggest crisis we've faced for generations.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey!